China's envoy to the Philippines is now a persona non grata in the municipality of Kalayaan in Palawan. Municipal Council member Philip Albaida was the one who authored the resolution on declaring Ambassador Wang Xilian persona non grata. This after Wang defended the Chinese Coast Guard's dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels near Ayungin Shoal. The Chinese embassy has yet to issue a statement on the matter.
The Philippines exposes China's actions in the West Philippine Sea during a gathering of defense chiefs from over 20 countries. Armed Forces Chief General Romeo Bronner Jr. says he presented several incidents showing China's aggression in Philippine waters. The latest was when the Chinese Coast Guard used water cannons on a Philippine Coast Guard vessel on the way to Ayungin Shoal. A representative from China was present at that conference, which was held in Fiji from August 14 to 16.
The world needs to know what's happening in the South China Sea. Ang sagot naman ng China was that unang-una sabi nila sumusunod sila sa international laws, no? Pangalawa, the South China Sea belongs to them because of their historical rights, sabi nila. And third is that the international ruling, yung arbitration of 2016, is unacceptable, invalid for them. Sumagot rin tayo that if they have a historical claim over the South China Sea, we have a historical claim over the West Philippine Sea.
He added the defense chiefs of participating countries, including China's, verbally agreed to promote rules-based international order.
Pag sinabi natin rules-based international order, ay ibig sabihin ay susunod tayo sa mga agreements katulad ng UNCLOS. No? At hindi dapat tayo gumamit ng dahas or coercive and dangerous tactics in order to promote our own interests, no? Pumayag naman lahat. And pero wala talaga yung resolution, walang written agreement, but it was just a verbal agreement among us participants.
A maritime affairs expert expects China to raise concerns if the U.S., Japan, and Australia push through with their planned joint Navy drills. Jay Batumbakal says China previously proposed that no military exercises should be held in the South China Sea without its permission. He notes the drills can be seen as measures to preserve freedom of navigation for all nations.
China will certainly make quite a bit of noise. They've always been protesting and at some point even interfering, not just shadowing any kind of military exercise in the South China Sea. For them, these are long-standing allies and partners, really, ever since the end of the Second World War. And all of them have also expressed concerns at various points in time, especially in recent years, over China's aggressive behavior in the South China Sea and its intention to turn the South China Sea into its own lake. No? So I think that these countries are really demonstrating, no, their resolve in making sure that the South China Sea remains open to all countries.
The Philippine Education Department defends their order to remove all wall decorations in public schools. Education spokesperson Michael Poa told Teleradio Serbisyo Vice President Sara Duterte, who is concurrently education chief, wants to ensure all students remain focused. She believes keeping classroom walls bare of decorations, such as photos of the national hero or sitting president, will improve the learning experience.
I know that the President Marcos and all other former presidents, Rizal, and all heroes past and present will not at all be bothered if learners focus on their teachers, lessons, projects, and assignments. The order is what it is. Take out everything on the wall and let learners focus on their study. Classroom and schools should be clean, orderly, and functional.
The Philippine Commission on Elections begins reprinting ballots for 10 villages affected by the territorial row between the cities of Makati and Taguig. COMELEC spokesperson John Rex Laudianco says the poll body is taking the Supreme Court's decision to award 10 villages to Taguig City as a judicial notice to prepare for the transfer of its voters. He says the poll body began preparations for the transfer as it awaits the Supreme Court's input on whether the 10 villages will remain under Makati City's jurisdiction for the polls in October. Laudianco assures the public the poll body is prepared for the candidacy filing and election proper, regardless of the High Court's response. Earlier, Makati officials insisted Taguig City has to secure a writ of execution before it can formally take over the affected villages.
What we are right now is starting the reprinting of the ballots for the 10 barangays. Originally, they had already been printed with the name of Makati City on top of the ballot. We had started the printing of that, naming those ballots into Taguig City. So what will happen is, if the decision pushes through, we'll be using the ballots named Taguig City. And we will be destroying, in the presence of the media and other stakeholders, the previously printed ballots for Makati City for full transparency. But if it goes the other way, then we will revert back to the ballots already printed for Makati City.
Former Environment Secretary Lito Atienza calls for the filing of charges against officials that approved reclamation projects in Manila Bay. Atienza says officials of the Reclamation Authority abused their power by issuing so many permits. He also calls for a complete halt of reclamation permit issuances. Early this month, President Marcos suspended all reclamation projects in Manila Bay pending a review of their impacts.